Saturday night, and we're about to discover who's got stars in their eyes. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your host, Matthew Kelly.
Welcome to Stars in Their Eyes, the last show in the series, which means we're only 1 week away from the live grand final. 1 week. Seven whole days of nervous, excited anticipation of the big event. When we started the series way back in March, the final was but a mere speck on the horizon. Now it's a huge spectacle, and it's almost upon us. One of tonight's star guests will join our 11 previous winners in the show that's going to dominate next Saturday night's viewing. And it's going to be a night to remember. What better way to start your bank holiday weekend? Now, next Saturday may be a big night for our finalists, but tonight is a big night for our last star guests of the series, any one of whom could step into the limelight of that live final. Like star guest number one, who's very keen to step up to stardom.
My name is Joanne Ravenscroft. I'm 27, and I live in Stoke-on-Trent in Staffordshire. Stoke's become quite a landmark now because Anthea Tinner's on everything, and she's from Stoke-on-Trent. We've also got the Potteries, of course. Fitness is really, really important to me, and I particularly like the step classes. We get everybody in there, and it's really good because it makes you realise that not everybody who goes to a health club looks like they just walked off Baywatch. And they're also friendly. I have a really good time with them. I used to sing from when I was about 8 in a concert party called the Red Coronations. We used to do songs from the shows, so it's a real thrill to get through to something like this. I was driving around a lot with the radio on, and this record just kept coming on over and over on every single channel, and I just started singing along to it, and that's how I found out that I sounded like it. I'm going to be very nervous when I walk through the doors tonight, but I know that my parents are going to burst with pride. I'm going to be nervous, but I'm just going to enjoy it.
She's a complete fitness fanatic. Say hello to Joanne Ravenscroft. The thing is, Joanne, now, I think you're a very brave girl. You wouldn't catch me with cameras in a gym watching me.
I was very brave that day, Matthew, because the camera, they just get closer and closer, and I hadn't shaved my legs. I got very worried, very worried.
But keeping in shape has done you a good turn, really, hasn't it? Because you won a beauty contest.
Yes, I did, yes. I went on holiday with a friend of mine, and one of these holiday camps, you know. Well, they wanted girls to enter this competition, so we put ourselves forward for it, and I won. But there was only three of us in the competition, so...
Now, your parents, you said, will be bursting with pride.
Yes,
about
they will,
tonight.
Definitely.
And especially as when you're aged 8 years old, they gave you a choice, didn't they?
Yes, they did. They asked me if I wanted to either take up ballet or singing. I was a bit like you, Matthew. I kept growing, you know, taller, taller. So too big to be a dancer.
You chose the singing instead
yes,
of the dancing.
Yes.
Tell us who you're going to be tonight, Joanne.
Tonight, Matthew, I'm going to be Sheryl Crow.
Sheryl Crow, a California girl! She likes to step and swim, but tonight, singing live, Joanne Ravenscroft is Sheryl Crow! There is no doubt you're a natural performer.
Thank you.
Do you think you made the right decision at 8 years old?
Yes, I think so.
I think you did.
I hope so.
Ladies and gentlemen, Joanne Ravenscroft as Sheryl Crow. Now let's meet star guest number two, a fine figure of a fella who fixes things in a feline food factory.
My name's Gary Coulthard. I work at a pet food factory in Worksop in Nottinghamshire, and I'm employed there as a mechanical engineering technician, which is a big posh word for a fitter. And what that means is I actually mend the machines when they break down. I've got three daughters, Samantha, Kerry and Lisa, and they're really proud of Dad going on telly.
That better?
Should be all right now, anyway. I've adjusted it, so I'll come back later.
Although the person I'm going to do tonight is a bit before their time, not quite in their era, they're really very, very proud, and they do like his music. The excitement's really mounting now, and I can't actually believe that I'm here, actually on Stars in Their Eyes. I had no idea how big the whole thing was. And the reaction I'm getting from the people at home, you know, the whole of Worksop, Carlton, Langold, all the outlying villages and everything, they're all going to be tuning in tonight. And I'm really, really excited about it.
And so he should be. Please welcome Gary Coulthard. Well, I'm sorry, Gary, I think you look right natty in that hairnet.
Well, I mean, a story of my life, Matthew. You know, first time on TV and everything. I've been really, really looking forward to it. And I have to go out in front of all these people in an hairnet, you know.
Life's like that, though. Yeah. How do you pronounce your name?
It's Coulthard.
Coulthard, yes. Not Coulthard.
Not Coulthard or... I can't say that one. There's one or two I can't say, but we've had all sorts of pronunciations, you know, Coulyard and Coulthard and all... But it is Coulthard.
Yes, well, your dad gave you that. I mean,
yeah, yeah. I'm glad you mentioned my dad, actually. My dad, George, I'd really like to take this opportunity to mention him, you know, and I really want to say how what a great fella he is. And I know he'll be the proudest man in Carlton and Lindrick Working Man's Club tonight after I've been on here, you know. He's a really smashing fella. He's been an inspiration to me.
Did he inspire you to your love of singing?
Oh, no, he can't sing. He can't sing, no. He's tone deaf in actual fact, but he's a smashing fella, you know. He can do everything else.
OK. Now, the person that you're going to be tonight had hits in the 70s. Yep. And, of course, you being in Manchester brought back memories for you, didn't it?
It did, yes. I was walking down here the other day from the hotel, and I came past the Free Trade Hall, and I didn't realise that it was there, you know. And as I looked, I saw all the posters and realised it was a Free Trade Hall. And back in the early 70s, I actually went there to see the man I'm going to do tonight in concert with my brother.
And it's all came.
He went in concert with my brother. Yeah. I went to see him with my brother.
Gary.
My brother doesn't sing either.
Just tell us who you're going to be tonight.
Tonight, Matthew, I'm going to be James Taylor.
James Taylor! Sweet baby James! We've fixed it for him, and tonight's singing live, Gary Coulthard is James Taylor!
Yesterday morning, they let me know we're gone. Suzanne, the plans they made put an end to you. I walked out this morning and I wrote down this song. I just can't remember who to send it to. I've seen fire and I've seen rain. I've seen sunny days that I thought would never end. I've seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I always thought that I'd see you again. Won't you look down upon me, Jesus? You gotta help me make a stand. You just gotta see me through another day. My My body's aching and my time is at hand. I won't make it any other way. Oh, I've seen fire and I've seen rain. I've seen sunny days that I thought would never end. I've seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. I always thought that I'd see you again. Oh, I've seen fire and I've seen rain. I've seen sunny days that I thought would never end. I've seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I always thought that I'd see you. See you one more time again. But I always thought that I'd see you again.
Well done.
Where's your hairnet when you need one?
I don't know.
Do you think your dad will have liked that?
Oh, I think he'll love it, yeah.
I'm telling you, Will. Well. Ladies and gentlemen, much, Gary Coulthard as James Taylor. Thank you. Well, we've seen fire and we've seen rain, and now we're going to see muscle and sweat as we meet star guest number three.
My name's Matt Ford, I'm 23 years old, and I'm in my final year studying for a B.Ed. In physical education at De Montfort University, Bedford. The course involves developing myself as a teacher and my skills in various sports and my teaching of various sports. But as part of the course, I'm majoring in athletics. I also enjoy playing football, tennis, basketball, badminton, anything you can name. I enjoy going down the gym with my friends. It's important not only just for me to keep fit personally, but to keep my fitness for the course, because the course is quite demanding physically. Singing has helped me as a stress relief, really, over the 4 years with a lot of work on at college. It's nice to get out there and do something that I enjoy. When the children I've taught so far see me on the television, I don't think they'll quite believe it's me without my shorts on anyway.
He seems like a jolly good sport. Please welcome Matt Ford. So you're an all-round sportsman, you would say, would you?
Yeah, definitely.
good, yes. Particularly football, because I gather you got a trophy for playing football.
Yes, Matthew, I won a trophy last year, Turkey of the Year Award, for missing the most open goals in the team.
Congratulations! Because I know that at college you're better known for your dancing rather than your singing. Why is that?
Yes, Matthew, myself and a couple of friends choreographed a strip routine for one of our friends' 21st birthday parties.
I love these stories.
Her name was Tracy, and we worked into the routine. As we turned round, we all dropped our trousers and we all had a letter of her name on our bum cheeks.
When did you start singing?
I started singing when I was about 4 or 5 years old. I was in a Christmas concert at my school. I sang Little Christmas Tree. Made my mum cry.
And your mum cried. Well, you see, you started then as a heartbreaker, and you're going to be a heartbreaker tonight, and heartbreaker is the clue we are searching for. Who are you going to be tonight, Matt?
Tonight, Matthew, I'm going to be Harry Connick Jr.
Harry Connick Jr. It had to be! He likes to get physical, but tonight, singing live, Matt Ford is Harry Connick Jr.
Wandered around and finally found the somebody who could make me be true, could make me be blue.
or even be glad just to be sad thinking of you. Some others I've seen might never be mean, might never be coarse or try to be boss, but they wouldn't do for nobody else. Gave me a thrill. With all your faults, I love you still. It had to be you, wonderful you. It had to be you. Somebody who could make me be true, could make me be blue, or even be glad just to be sad thinking of you. Some others I've seen might never be me. They might never be cross or try to be boss, they wouldn't do for nobody else. Gave me a thrill. With all your faults, I love you still. Baby, it had to be you, wonderful you. It had to be you.
Weeping, all the other girls are swooning, your broken hearts all over the place. Was it good for you?
It's fantastic.
It's a good feeling, isn't it?
Great feeling.
And this time, when you get back to college, stick to singing and forget the dancing, if I were you. Ladies and gentlemen, Matt Ford as Harry Connick Jr. Well, it's been a physically active first half, don't you think? What with all that step aerobics and pumping iron, I think we should take a break and devote the second half of the show to rest and recreation. I'll see you in a bit. Welcome back to Stars in Their Eyes. Now, we've all had a chance to get our breath back and maybe you've had some sort of refreshment. I can't think of anything more refreshing myself than a pint of foaming ale served up in a traditional tavern by a florid-faced yeoman of the bar. Or even better, star guest number four.
My name's Stan Fuller. I'm originally from London, and now I'm living in the northeast in a place called Newton Aycliffe with my wife Jennifer. We run a pub called The Huntsman. Being a pub landlord for me means a challenge of all sorts, really. It brings out my personality, and I help other people bring out theirs in what I do. My job involves really generating business, looking after the community. Working with my wife Jennifer, I find brilliant. I discovered that I had this sound of who I'm going to be by singing karaoke. Really take the mick, I suppose, first of all. But since then, I've done it so many times that it's like second nature. And everybody said, you should go in for Stars in Their Eyes doing this. They're all rooting for me. They all want me to do well. And I just hope I don't let them down.
Time, please, ladies and gentlemen.
Well, it's time we met him, Stan Fuller. Look at his face, just look at his face. Kenny Rogers, isn't it? Kenny Rogers. Now, you're not going to be that, otherwise I wouldn't have mentioned it, would I?
That's true.
Who's your musical hero, Stan?
Cliff Richard.
Cliff Richard. So absolutely, you're obviously not going to be him, as you mentioned him so early on.
No, I'm not his size.
No, you're not his size, actually. Funny enough, you actually do look a little bit like the person that you're going to be, but we'll get on to that later, because you've actually lost weight to become this person, haven't you?
Yes, I've lost 2 stone.
Congratulations. Did you give up drinking?
No, I don't drink.
Why is this? What?
My dad took me out when I was 15 years of age and bought me 8 pints of beer and a whiskey.
Oh.
And I was so violently ill all night long, and that was it.
That you never touched another drop. You don't smoke either, do you?
No, I don't smoke. I found 20 senior service on the pavement when I was 8 years of age, and I smoked all 20. And I was so violently ill, my mother hit me and said, I'm sorry, you should have brought those cigarettes home for me.
Now, you didn't apply yourself for this show, did you?
No.
I have Axel in the pub on Fridays, and one particular girl singer applied for me.
And you got an audition from that? And here you are.
And here I am.
Who are you going to be, Stan?
Tonight, Matthew, I'm going to be Barry Gibb.
Barry Gibb, the BG of the Bee Gees. He's a pipe-pulling publican, and tonight, singing live, Stan Fuller is Barry Gibb. What a good thing you went for the tight jeans in the end. Is it very different from doing it on the karaoke in your pub?
It certainly is, Matthew.
What's the difference?
It's just the adrenaline inside.
I know, you gave us a buzz as well. Ladies and gentlemen, Stan Fuller as Barry Gibb.
Hello, Stan.
And so we come to star guest number 5, last of the series, but by no means least.
My name is Sandra Robinson, and I live in the southwest of London, and I'm a single mum with 3 kids. I work as an admin assistant in the Lambeth Health Authority, basically dealing with complaints from patients in hospitals. Every Wednesday, I attend a rehearsal with the choir, which is the London Gospel Community Choir. I enjoy singing very much. My sister tells me that I started singing from when I was 8 years old. I write my own songs. I have a keyboard at home. I can't play properly, but it's enough to help me with what I'm writing. I've taken people's accents off for years. Don't ask me why, it's just me. But I just love singing. Singing, really, for me, singing is my life. I love singing that much, and that overcomes my shyness.
She's shy but not retiring. Please welcome Sandra Robinson. Sandra, I love the way people use their singing, and as you said, you use it to cover your shyness. Is this a big problem for you?
It's not a very big problem, but you could say that's what I do, yeah, with my singing.
We see you in the choir there. I've always thought it must be marvellous to be in a choir.
It is, it's great.
Good fun?
You know, you learn a lot and you travel around.
Have you been far with the choir?
Been to Sweden and Holland.
Oh, you do get about, don't you? You want to change your profession, don't you? What to?
I want to get into the field of child protection.
And how are you going about that?
At the moment, I've returned to education. I'm doing an access course in social science, so thoroughly enjoying it.
Well, you might be shy, but you're a very brave woman, aren't you? Tell us a little bit about the person you're going to be tonight.
She's a soul stroke jazz singer, and she's had an 80s hit.
And that is the song you're going to sing tonight. Tell us who you're going to be, Sandra.
Tonight, Matthew, I'm going to be Anita Baker.
Anita Baker, the sweet soul singer. She's waited a long time for this. Tonight, singing live, Sandra Robinson is Anita Baker. I know you're changing professions, but just promise me you'll never give up singing.
I won't.
I don't believe it. Now you've stopped singing, you've gone shy again, haven't you? Ladies and gentlemen, Sandra Robinson as Anita Baker. Thank you, Sandra. And as Anita Baker walks off, I expect she's wondering if she'll be walking back through those famous doors as tonight's star winner. Someone's got to do it, and in a few moments' time, the studio audience will decide exactly which someone will fill that last place in the live grand final, alongside our 11 previous winners, who were, of course, Maria McKee, Bobby V, Mario Lanza, Fats Domino, Celine Dion, Dinah Washington, Gilbert O'Sullivan, Marty Pello, Heather Small, Lou Gramm, and of course, Glenn Tilbrook. That's 7 days from now when you at home will have the opportunity to voice your opinion by taking part in the great telephone vote. But before we go any further, I'd like to thank the tens of thousands who applied, the hundreds who auditioned, and the 60 star guests who made it onto the series. But now, for the last time, who will be tonight's winner? Will it be Sheryl Crow, James Taylor, Harry Connick Jr., Barry Gibb, or Anita Baker? And there they are. We wish them all the best. Stand by, studio audience. Cast your votes now. And the winner is Anita Baker! Of disbelief shot across your face.
I don't know what to say.
Of course you don't know what to say. You suffer from shyness. Did you forget for a minute? Still, we'll be able to keep you singing now, so you won't be shy for very long, will you?
No.
I must say, Sandra, though, I know you're changing your profession, but I think you ought to consider perhaps, you know, another profession.
Mm.
That of singing. Has it crossed your mind?
Yes.
I thought perhaps it might. I'm well pleased for you. Thank what with you. That strong competition as well. Congratulations.
Thank you.
I'm going to get you to sing again in a minute.
Okay.
Is that all right?
Yeah.
Oh, didn't think you'd mind. Well, an exciting end to an exciting series and the perfect appetizer for the feast of entertainment that'll be next week's live grand final, to which you're all cordially invited. I'll be there, of course, and so too will Sandra Robinson, who will now sing us out once again as Anita Baker. Good night.
Sorry to interrupt, but as Matthew said, next week it's the big one, and that live grand final begins on Saturday at 8:15.